Good morning. We are on the road to Appalachia, and we just went through St. Louis, but we still want to kind of do our morning devotions and allow for you to join us. So we're going to tape these just a little before and see if they'll get to you about 8 o'clock time. We'll see. We have to record first and then send it to YouTube. So we'll go ahead and have our morning devotion. So we're going to be following a brief service of the Word. So we'll begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, as we hear your Word this day, may it continue to give to us your Son, Jesus Christ, who is the light of our salvation. As we hear your Word today, also remind us of the great workings of your Spirit, that even in the midst of turmoil, we have the ability to continue to serve you and know that you will take care of us. We pray these things, asking you to remind us of these things, in Jesus' name, amen. So we're going to be reading from Acts chapter 9, and Selah is going to read that for us.
All of it?
All of Acts, well, how many verses are there?
43.
Hold on. I should have looked. I wanted to do the first part. About Paul. Okay, yeah, starting at 23. Go to like 23 to 43.
Okay. When many days were fulfilled.
You have to talk louder.
And when many days were fulfilled, the Jews took counsel together to kill him. But their plot became known to Saul, and they watched the gates also day and night that they might kill him. But his disciples took him by night and let him down through the wall, lowering him in a basket. When he was come to Jerusalem, he essayed to join himself to the disciples. And they were all afraid of him, not believing that he was a disciple. But Barnabas took him and brought him to the apostles and declared unto them how he had seen the Lord in the way, and that he had spoke to him, and how at Damascus he had preached boldly in the name of Jesus. And he was with them, going in and going out of Jerusalem, preaching boldly in the name of the Lord. And he spake and disputed against the Christian Jews, but they were seeking to kill him. And when the brethren knew it, they brought him down to Caesarea, and sent him forth to Tarsus. So the church throughout all Judea and Galilee and Samaria had peace, being edified, and walking in the fear of the Lord, and in the comfort of the Holy Spirit was multiplied.
That was to 43?
Oh. And it came to pass, as Peter went throughout all parts, he came down also to the saints that dwell at Lydia. And there he found a certain man named Aeneas, who had kept his bed 8 years, and he was palsied. Peter said unto him, Aeneas, Jesus Christ healeth thee, arise. I have a weird version. It's fine. Arise and make thy bed. And straightway he arose. And all that dwelt in Lydia and in Sharon saw him, and they turned to the Lord. Now there was at Joppa a certain disciple named Tabitha, which by interpretation is called Dorcas. This woman was full of good works and alms deeds, which she did. And it came to pass in those days, she fell sick and died. And when they had washed her, they laid her in an upper chamber. And as Lydia was nigh unto Joppa, the disciples, hearing that Peter was there, sent two men unto him, entreating him, delay not to come unto us. But Peter arose and went with them. And when he was come, they brought him into the upper chamber. And all the widows stood by him weeping, and showing the coats of garments which Dorcas made, while she was with them. But Peter put them all forth, and kneeled down and prayed, and turn into the body, he said. Tabitha, arise. And she opened her eyes, and when she saw Peter, she sat up. And he gave her his hand and raised her up. He called the saints and widows. He presented her alive. And it became known throughout all Joppa, and many believed on the Lord. And it came to pass that he abode many days in Joppa with one Simon, a tanner.
All right. Thank you. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Just briefly, four different stories of that kind of come together. One of them, the miracle of Saul, who also we know as Paul, who was saved by people that he was trying to kill originally, but he convincing them that he was a believer now, became a part of that Christian church, bringing him into that safety net. The Holy Spirit does that. And we hear these other stories that these miracles are happening. Boom, 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 boom. It's kind of amazing how the early church saw these things, and it was all to point people to Jesus as the one who brought life, brought abundant life, eternal life. And so there's Tabitha. I used to live in a dorm called Dorcas. Always thought that was weird. I never knew what Dorcas was. So.
Well, now you do.
Well, I did then, too, after I lived there.
Never mind.
Woman who was raised from the dead by Peter. Peter couldn't do any of that beforehand. It was only through the Holy Spirit. So we also, on Sundays, receive miracles. Miracles of the true body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The miracle of our faith being strengthened and staying in that true faith. Great, great blessings to see the church continue to receive those gifts of life. We're going to go ahead and continue with the Lord's Prayer. And so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And we pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we ask that you would bless my family on this trip, keep us safe. And we also ask you, Lord God, that you would be with all the farmers and as they enter into harvest and continue harvest. We pray, Heavenly Father, also that you would be with all those who are driving trucks for harvest. Keep them safe, Lord. Not only that, Lord, just those be with those who are continuing to do their jobs that they do every single day. I'm serving you and bringing glory to your name. We pray these things in your Son's name. Amen. And let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, bless you today, and may each and every day be a blessing to you. Go out in the Lord.